the challenge for anyone who's got a liquid load is you can't lash down liquid. Our trucks aren't full for a lot of the time. You couple that with the fact that you're going around corners and all of a sudden you have a load on board which can be up to 42 tonne, rapidly pushing to the side of the tanker.
There's a 2 second slosh cycle, so the milk sloshing backwards and forwards typically takes 2 seconds. This is a model of as true to life as you can get of milk actually sloshing in a tanker. It continues on for quite some time. Going through a roundabout, sloshes backwards and forwards. The timing is critical. If you pick the timing through a roundabout and your timing of speed, angle of attack and angle of departure is 2 seconds, you will roll over. Our animation shows that in an S-bend, the problem is we've got a dynamically moving centre of gravity. The slosh factor is perfectly timed to tip the truck over, all the weights on one side. The other one we've got with a dynamic problem is a cement mixer or concrete truck. Agitators only run one way, anti-clockwise. That means all the material is packing up on one side. If you go around a left-hand bend with that material packing up on one side, you've got a bit of a problem because all your weight's on that side. The animation shows that at a roundabout, you'll come in under brakes, you're almost stopping, so the material moves forward and you've got the camber of the road to help you stay upright. As you go around, the weight's on the inside of the curve, helps you stay upright. It's only when you're exiting the roundabout, turning left, that you have the problem, because all the weight's now on the outside of the curve and it can tip you over.